Students, in the previous video lectures, we have learned about self-induction, mutual induction, self-induction due to solenoid and mutual induction due to solenoid. We will solve few problems in this video session on self-induction and mutual induction. A solenoid is of length 50 centimeter and has a radius of 2 centimeter. So length of solenoid is equal to 50 centimeter, that is 50 into 10 power minus 2 meter, and has a radius 2 centimeter, that is 2 into 10 power minus 2 meter. It has 500 number of turns. Around its central section, a coil of 50 turns is wound. Calculate mutual inductance of the system. So let me consider number of turns in the primary coil is equal to 500. Number of turns in the secondary coil is equal to 50. So there is one solenoid placed inside the other. So there were some n number of turns. Like for example, I can take this as one solenoid. And around this, there is another solenoid. Now, there will be mutual induction. The current, if current is passing in the outer one, there will be mutual induction on the second one. I want to now calculate mutual induction due to that. What is formula for mutual induction? We already derived equation for that. Mutual induction is mu naught, number of turns in the primary coil, number of turns in the secondary coil, area of cross section of the coil divided by length L. So mutual induction M can be written as 4 pi into 10 power minus 7. Number of turns in the primary coil, it is 500 into secondary coil is 50. Area of cross section is pi r square. R is 2 into 10 power minus 2 whole square divided by length of the coil is 50 into 10 power minus 2. If you evaluate this total, you will be getting mutual inductance of the coil. If you calculate this total, you will be getting 78.98 into 10 power minus 6 Henry. That is answer for this question. A solenoid coil has 50 turns per centimeter. Number of turns per centimeter is 50. Along its length and a cross-sectional area of 4 into 10 power minus 4 meter square and 200 turns of another wire is wound round the first solenoid coaxially. 200 number of turns are another coil is being wounded on the solenoid coaxially. The two coils are electrically insulated from each other. Calculate mutual inductance between the two coils. You should calculate mutual inductance between the two coils. We need to calculate mutual inductance between the two coils. Mutual inductance between the two coils is equal to mu naught, number of turns in the primary coil, number of turns in the secondary coil, area of cross section into length L. As we know, like you have a solenoid. This is one solenoid. Let me take this is primary coil. And there is another solenoid which is wounded upon this. Right? Area of cross section of these two is the same. It is 4 into 10 power minus 4 meter square. but number of turns in the primary and secondary are different. Number of turns in the secondary coil is mentioned as, number of turns in the secondary coil, it is mentioned as 200, but number of turns in the primary coil, small n, which is equal to number of turns in the primary coil divided by length L, is equal to 50 per centimeter. You should convert it into meter, 10 power minus 2. Number of turns in the primary coil is equal to 50 divided by 10 power minus 2 into length, you can take it as 1 meter. This is equal to 50 into 10 power 2. Number of turns in the primary coil is equal to 5000 turns. That is number of turns in the primary coil. Area of cross section is known to you. Length, you can take it as 1 meter, so that you can just write it as capital M is equal to 4 pi into 10 power minus 7 into number of turns in the primary coil is equal to 5000. Number of turns in the secondary coil is equal to 200. Area of cross section is 4 into 10 power minus 4 divided by length of the solenoid. I will be taking it as 1 meter. If you evaluate this, you will be getting total mutual induction, and it is nearly 5.03 into 10 power minus 4 Henry. Next problem. A toroidal solenoid with an air core. A toroidal solenoid will be like this. Like this is a toroidal solenoid where you have number of turns wounded like this. And magnetic field due to this toroidal solenoid will be equal to mu naught capital N I divided by 2 pi capital R. This is equation for magnetic field due to toroidal solenoid. Now, the average radius of this toroidal solenoid is given as 0.15 meter. Area of cross section, A is equal to 12 into 10 power minus 4 meter square, and the number of turns, which are given as 1200. Obtain self induction of the toroid. We know self induction L is equal to N pi divided by I. This is N into pi is B dot A divided by I. So L can be written as N into B is magnetic field. Magnetic field will be mu naught capital N I divided by 2 pi capital R into area of cross section divided by I. This I and I gets cancelled. So L will be equal to mu naught N square A divided by 2 pi capital R. All the values you can substitute here. 4 pi into 10 power minus, I'll write it above. So this gives you L is equal to 4 pi into 10 power minus 7. Number of turns is given as 1200 whole square into area of cross section 12 into 10 power minus 4 divided by 2 pi into radius is 0.15 meter. This 2 pi into 2 gets cancelled. From here you can calculate self induction. It is nearly 12 into 10 power 4. This is 10 power minus 3 into 12 into 10 power minus 4 divided by 2 is there in the numerator. It is 2 into this and 15 into 10 power minus 2. This 10 power minus 2, this 10 power minus 2 gets cancelled. Remained will be only minus 2. And 3 fourths 12, 3 fives 15. So L will be equal to If you calculate this, what you are getting? (76.8×10⁻⁵). Are you sure? Coming to the next question, a second coil of 300 turns is wound closely on the toroid above. If the current in the primary coil is increased from 0 to delta I is equal to 2 ampere and in time delta T is equal to 0.05 second, obtain the induced EMF in the secondary coil. So induced EMF in the secondary coil is equal to mutual induction M into DI divided by DT. Mutual induction we have already calculated. So EMF in the secondary coil is equal to mutual induction. We have got it nearly 23×10⁻⁴. 23×10⁻⁴ into di by dt, it is 2 ampere divided by 0.05. So ES is equal to 46×10⁻⁴ into 10⁻+2 divided by 5. 5 nines, 45 nearly. So EMF in the secondary coil is 9×10⁻² volt. This is equation for voltage in the secondary coil. Students, in the previous lectures, we have already learned that there will be EMF induced whenever there is relative motion between coil and bar magnet. Likewise, we can construct an electric generator by using that principle, where whenever a coil is being rotated in external magnetic field, it will induce some EMF. That's the basic principle of constructing electric generator. This is electric generator. Okay. Now, electric generator works under the principle of works under the principle of electromagnetic induction. So what happens in this is, the basic principle involved in construction of electric generator is, when a coil is being rotated in external magnetic field, there will be change in the orientation of the coil. Because the orientation of the coil is undergoing change, there is some flux change in the coil. As the flux is undergoing change within that rotating coil, there will be some EMF induced, and that EMF induced can be calculated by this equation. Delta pi by delta t, which gives you pi b dot a, I can write it as EMF is equal to minus of b into, magnetic field is not changing here, area of cross section is not changing here, area of cross section of the coil would be remain same, magnetic field is remain same, only the angle is rotated, like the orientation of the coil gets rotated, therefore cos theta is variable. I can write it as d by dt of cos theta. Cos theta differentiation is minus sine theta, minus of minus will become plus B A into sine theta. For n number of turns, EMF induced is equal to B N A into sine theta. This is number one. So as we know, theta can be written as omega into T, where omega is angular velocity of that coil, T is time taken. You can just substitute here, EMF is equal to BNA into sine of omega into T, which resumes sinusoidal function. This is representing variable EMF in coil. So the EMF induced is in the form of E naught into sine of omega into t, which is alternating EMF. This is mathematical equation for EMF developed in the electric generator. Now let us see how this variable EMF is achieved in the coil. Now observe the animation provided in the figure. In the animation, you can clearly see that there is a coil. There is a coil which is placed perpendicular to magnetic field initially, and that coil is rotated like this. When the coil is rotated, in the first, like initially, coil is placed perpendicular to the magnetic field. Next, it have rotated by one quarter, and then next quarter, and then next quarter, and then next quarter. Divide the total rotation of the coil into four different quarters. In the first quarter, if you observe, you can see that for every quarter, the orientation angle would undergo change. First, initially, it is 0 to 90 degrees. From 90 to 180 degrees. 180 degrees to 270 degrees. 270 degrees to 360 degrees. For every one rotation of the coil which is rotated over there, the sides of the coil are interchanging. For first half rotation, the coil end, see here we have ends of the coil. Let me take, this is A and this is B, and the other side it is C and the other one it is D. For the first half rotation, the end AB is in contact with this brush B1, and this I can take it as B2. With B1, AB is in contact in the first half rotation. Now when it is completing one rotation, what would happen is the second one comes in contact with this B1. Like that, for every half rotation, the directions of the EMF produced is being interchanged, which results change in the EMF produced, and such type of EMF which is continuously altering with respect to time is said to be alternating current. You can clearly see how how the EMF is induced in this graph. You can check it in this graph. First, initially, the coil is placed vertically. In the vertical plane, coil is placed like this. And it is a starting from zero angle. Okay? Therefore, EMF developed is zero. And next, it is rotated by one quarter. When it is rotated by one quarter, what happens is that, see, this is the side B and A. BA is left side. As the coil is rotated one quarter, the EMF is being induced and it is increased. And in the next quarter, the BA coil is coming down. As a result, the EMF induced will be in opposite direction. Therefore, it decreases. And then again, the coil is coming back to vertical position. And in this vertical position, magnetic flux change will be again zero. And then the coil is being rotated in opposite direction. Now it is C and this is D. Initially it is AB. Now it is a DC, which is in contact with this point. Right? The turn, it is completely reversed. So because CD have come to the other side, the EMF developed is in opposite direction. And in the next quarter, EMF will be increased. So therefore, for every one quarter, the EMF direction undergo change. Depending upon that, in the first quarter rotation, EMF is increased, next quarter decreased. And then in the next quarter, it is increased in opposite direction. And then in the next quarter, again, it is coming back to zero. So for every one complete revolution of the coil in external magnetic field, the EMF is altering. Such EMF which is developed in electric generator is alternating EMF, which is practically obtained in power stations. This is how, by the principle of electromagnetic induction, we are rotating the coil in external magnetic field, which is mechanical energy. And this mechanical energy is producing EMF in the coil. and that EMF is stored in the battery. This is battery. Like, of course, the EMF is being, like, this battery is being charged. So this is being stored, and it is a load resistance. It's not exactly battery. It is load resistance. We can even, this is load resistor. So through this load resistor, current can pass through. That is how alternating EMF is being developed in electric generator. And this is AC generator. If you replace these slip rings, these are the slip rings. If you replace these slip rings with commutator, then alternating EMF, which is produced here, can be converted into direct EMF. The directions of, like, these can be reversed. The direction of EMF, which is in the negative cycle, can be reversed by placing a commutator over there. Therefore, AC generator can be converted into DC by using a commutator in place of the slip rings. One question here. A coil of 800 turns, number of turns is equal to 800, and area of cross section is equal to 50 centimeter square, makes 10 RPS, 10 rotations per second. That means angular velocity is given as 10 rotations per second about an axis in its own plane in a magnetic field. B is equal to 100 Gauss. Gauss is the CGS unit of magnetic field. You can convert this into SI system. Of course, this is in CGS. This is in CGS. Gauss perpendicular to its axis. What is the instantaneous induced EMF in the coil? So instantaneous induced EMF is B N A sine omega into T. This is instantaneous EMF. B is magnetic field. It is 100 Gauss. Number of turns are 800. Area of cross section is 50 centimeter square into sine of. Omega is rotations per second. I can write it as 10 into 1 rotation is equal to 2 pi radian into time taken T. This is equal to 85 is 40 into 2, 3, 4, 5. 10 power 5 sine of 2 times 20 pi T. This is EMF induced in the coil. And this EMF, actually, I should convert it in, convert this into SI system, and I need to substitute here. If I convert this into SI system, you will be getting it as 4 into 10 power 5 into centi is 10 power minus 4 whole square, and Gauss is 10 power minus 4 Tesla into sine of 20 pi T. This is equal to 10 power minus 4. This 10 power minus 4 0 gets cancelled. Remained is 10 power minus 2. 4 into 10 power minus 2 sine 20 pi T. So this gives you 0.04 sine 20 pi T. The maximum EMF which is produced in the process is 0.04 volt. Next question is, there is a person who is pedaling a stationary bicycle and it is having n number of turns where n is equal to 100 turns. And area of cross section is equal to 0.10 meter square. The coil rotates at half a revolution per second. Omega is equal to half revolution per second. It is placed in the uniform magnetic field of 0.01 Tesla perpendicular to the axis of rotation of the coil. What is the maximum voltage generated? In order to find out maximum voltage generated, you have EMF induced is equal to NBA into sine of omega into T. As we know, for maximum value of sine omega t is equal to 1. Therefore, EMF induced will be equal to NBA. Number of turns is equal to 100. B is magnetic field 0.01 Tesla. Area of cross section, it is 0.10. That is area of cross section. If you multiply this, you will be getting EMF. And this will be the maximum value of EMF generated within this coil.